Hey, how y'all doing? You know the good old saying, you don't know where you're going if you don't know where you're coming from. So put some thought into this one, and I like to reminisce. I really like to reminisce. This is the whole point of my YouTube channel. This is how it started. I wanted to save space on memory, and I wanted to be able to, just on a dull day, on a sad day, a down day, just go back and be able to relive moments, things I did, places I visited, people I was with. And that is really the essence of how the channel started. As we come to the end of 2023, I just thought, you know what, let me just do a little quick compilation of all the cool, interesting stuff I did over the year. I'm not gonna kill you all with it. It's gonna be short, it's gonna be sweet. I'm gonna get the best bits only. And I'll probably narrate as we go along, post the links for where the videos came from in case you're interested in checking them out. Yeah, the mountain mullet boy. It all started in Blanchard's. We make a 2 night, 2 days camping mission, and oh my God, the highlight of this thing for me was just seeing the tent. Yeah.
A two-person tent.
Two-person tent.
Now watch the size of me and telling me, yeah, that go up. Come around here and see this. Watch your way. I can't show that one for you.
I don't go back.
And I'm a short man.
Hey, we say the man pull a measure. The man pull a measuring tape.
Yeah.
Oh Lord.
That go fit there.
Oh Lord, oh Lord.
But it's a little long, so.
We had some real interesting food too, man. We had a mountain mullet, crayfish, Barry Pass finally with the half a tattoo he had for Varun. Alan show up with chicken and he make a pilau for the boys. Yeah, it was a good line. Next up, I went down Rio and I meet my partner Maiku, aka Squirrel. And I met his pet squirrel and also his pet duck, Laser. Hey, Mike's, this duck playing up here.
Laser, boy.
Laser? Laser can go in the pot. Watch out, George! Watch out! Come quiet country to get good living, you know? Good living, you know? As I was down in the south, I decided to check in with our next nice south crew of mine. Why in the back of God back? It have a house with a helicopter in the yard, dog.
That's where the boys touch down.
Fellas! Fellas, I from up in the north, eh? Hey, up in the north, you see Benz and Beamer and thing in the backyard, eh?
Helicopter.
What the hell is that? What the hell is this? Don't think I lie. Helicopter in the front yard. Them fellas tried their very best to get me lost somewhere in the back day. Driving by Dolce the Mansion, Brothers Road, Sisters Road, I don't know where the hell they carry me. I wasn't lost. I know where I was. But the best part about this was, there was bailing a river. Cascadu by Dave. Small ant.
Yes.
Hey.
That comes in that.
Are you going? You leave it, it didn't go anywhere.
Yeah,
nice cusky, nice cusky.
He big.
Nice what they're finding. Plus these redhead sliders that don't really belong in the water. So this here is a side neck turtle, and unlike regular turtles that's put the neck straight back into the body, this one just goes side to side. I hope I ain't bite there. See, side neck turtle. Looking very well. Maestro. Match. Oh, match. Where are they? How you catch ya? Flathead cascadu on the left. Might be difficult to see on your regular cascadu on the right. AKA a chato. After that, I had some footage I was taking just off of kicks about doing a solo camping on Shaka Shakari, and I decided I could make a video out of that. I think the height of this for me was shooting that Kubera snapper early in the morning. I wasn't sure my gun would have done the trick. At this very moment, a million thoughts entered into my head. Namely, is my gun rigged properly that I would be able to connect a solid fish like this? I don't feel comfortable taking the shot because I don't know how the gun performs with this new setup. that was a good shot.
Next thing was waking up in the middle of the night twice to like a thunderstorm and almost on the brink of getting wet inside the hammock.
Last time I used this was probably 3 years ago, but it will keep the mosquitoes out. But I guess if rain falling, that doesn't really matter. So, home sweet home for the night.
Remember that storm that was supposed to pass through? Well, it's here now and it's soaking my rain fly. Probably can't take another half hour of this.
Yes, I was a nasty surprise about half one this morning. Any more wetting and I'll get soaked. I had to re-engineer the rain fly. Yep. Good night, folks.
And most importantly for me, like, I went out on the beach a couple times during the night, specifically hoping to see one of them hard-shell turtles come up, a green or a hawksbill. And sure enough, I do believe, what was it? I think it was a hawksbill. I just called it before I see it. I saw a hawksbill making a nest. That was damn nice to see.
Morning, folks. Made it through the night safe and sound.
Oh yeah, we definitely had some more visitors, more than just the one that I came across last night.
If I remember correctly, early in the year the water was still dirty, not good for diving at all, but you know, we thirsty, we had to go out there and at least gain the groove for when things get good, we'll be primed.
Body to check the fizz with a gun. Well, if it's so shallow there, you can see the bottom. What? You what? You can't see the bottom? Pressure!
If I remember correctly, the heights of this one was Mike's silently shoot a lobster and his spear stick up down there. But he come up on the surface and he tell me he need help to extract his spear. He never say he shoot a lobster. So when I go down, I jump back when I find a lobster attached to the bucket.
What is
hell he sung in there? I don't know this man going down deep. I hate to extract a shaft, especially in this kind of milky, stinky, dirty water where you can't see what's going on. It's easy to get anxiety down there because you're not seeing, you could get wrapped up, you could put up your head, but if your partner's spare, I guess the hunting comes to a stop. We gotta take this out. So this is me breeding up, going down to dive and see what the whole situation is like. You have to assess before you know how to help, right? I'm following his shooting line all the way down, and I remember a million times I've been doing this for my coup, and I'm getting annoyed. What in the secret lobster shot is this? Nah, the squirrel moves so sneaky the man shoot a lobster. The spear and exit the lobster, going in and sticking the rocks behind. Come up and never say nothing. You're looking for some clout.
That day was hard but still fun, and we managed to land some fish in the cooler. We lungs get a little exercise and we're ready for the rest of the year. After that dive video, I changed it up by showing some of the animals we have in the forest using camera traps. I know this one was a real big hit. After that, we celebrated Kevin and Daniel's birthday doing a dive in the East Coast, where I famously forgot home my fins, and also a nice, sweet kind of beach line on Paria.
So we're going out for a crack shot, the back shot birthday. And like a true man, he bring his woman to do his business. My boy just come out here to have a good time.
Boy, this man forgets his fins alone. His fins alone!
So this is who the captain wife make this?
Yeah.
That is love. Oh, yeah, that is good living.
Take look at
that. Look at that.
No, the tree are
a vlogging dog? That is the man called Tony. That is Finn's man. Look at you. You special. You got two whole cascadu. In Kunaham, you know? This one has some quality grades in it. None of them shot by me because we're nearly a fin home. That is what has happened. Yeah. Some more greys in there. But you know what's the best thing I shoot? Dance?
Footage! Footage!
That's right.
1 week later.
Okay. Imagine it's your birthday and you're organizing right. Too, eh? Checking money, checking head, who on Maxi, who on boat.
Okay, Imran, you put Imran?
Who bring Finn, who ain't bring Finn?
Dog.
A few moments later.
Remember that movie Leonardo DiCaprio, The Beach? That's what Paria turned into now. That is what Paria turned into now. Take a little. What we say here? Good day, good day. Welcome to Paria Bay, bienvenido a Paria Bay. You have so much things I could recall from Paria, but lighting fire, roasting kebabs, the waterfall, man, all that was just sweet vibes. In the words of Brody Moss, will we have fire, baby?
Yes, we have fire!
We have fire!
We have fire!
Fire!
We have fire!
Fire!
We have fire!
We have fire, baby!
Hey, you almost catch? Hey, yeah, man, he's smoking, blow. Blow. Blow, God, blow.
There's no way.
There, already. Blow. Nice, blow it again. And we need something heavy to go on top of that. How could I forget the maxi ride too? And from the way home, not including some spearfishing we do out on the beach. Butterfish, and it's a nice one here, dog snapper. I shoot that.
Okay.
I shoot the next nice fish. Yeah, these two is me. Butterfish, yeah, and a yellow jack.
Okay.
So, you scaling? You gonna clean them up? But now you.
I'll try.
Yeah, we'll take it by the river. This is all I wanna do. All I wanna do.
My wife likes to remind me Daniel is a whole scene, a whole vibe and a whole energy. It was like this all the way till we reach out.
That was epic back-to-back weekends. I could do it something like that right now. But anyway, moving on. I think this was our next spearfishing mission, and I realized I started to get seasick when I was out there on the boat.
Any fish boy, poor boy.
He nearly blew off the head like.
Where?
If I hit headshot, then I have no head enough.
No head.
This was one of them days where kind of weird things were showing up. We started finding sea cucumbers, I find a giant clam outside there, and you know me, I had to eat them thing raw.
Take two.
Ah, yes, I. Rich, wonderful goodness. Hey, what you call on it now? For some I seen that.
Cheers, man.
Cheers.
Oh, never eat that before? What about this? Oh, never eat this before?
Yeah. One. Two.
Nah. Cutting my muscle, I am cutting my muscle.
Yeah, keep it rolling. Carrot?
Yeah. Alright, so if you watch inside of here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That is supposed to be the edible bits of it. We have to scrape it off, and that's what we cook. It's supposed to come out like calamari. So pause it.
And last but not least on this day, we end up shooting 2 nice big pag for the north at the end of the day. And if I remember better than that, them fellas sabotage me right after. They make me jump back in with our next man gun, and they never tell me the safety was on. Line up on our next big bag and pressure under the water.
Is it on? You have him there?
Yeah.
Lucky shots, you call this?
Chimbalas. I call this one. Chimbalas.
Remember what I told you about? They give my next man gun and they forget to tell me the safety was on. Well, this is it. This was our next nice fish, and from the time I realized the trigger and pressed it, me ain't even bother.
Sabotage! Sabotage! The shot ain't come off! The trigger stick! On today's pesh, where 3 man get seasick. Well, 4 men. Not too bad at all. Not too bad at all.
After that was my yearly pilgrimage to go out on the kingfish grounds in La Follette with Hills. And man, oh man, that didn't disappoint. I went chasing like a double digit plus type kingfish. And to my surprise, my partner Mike, who never do this before on the north, he come out on top. That day was all for Mike's. To start the thing with, he see a, the captain see a barracuda from on top of the boat. He jump in inside a day with his spear gun without fin, mass or kind of thing, fussy thirsty. And he still end up shooting the barra. What a start for he day. Oh Lord, boy Mike's, you run from your way.
I don't have much stuff.
Oh, you coming back, you coming
just
back.
Just hold on the boat, hold on the boat.
Hold on the boat.
Yeah, so in all the excitement day, a nice barra. He probably have about 8 pounds. But in all the excitement, watch where the barra going. Hey, yo, yo, he behind you. He behind you on your right. Look at this showdown. Yes, yes, yes. Connect. He miss? Wait, I'm... He would have... Oh no, he connect, he connect. He connect. I come into here. Yeah, oh!
I'll say this again, I never had a bad day with Hills. I mean, I never say I was always catching fish, eh? But I'll say I never had a bad day with Hills. Always learn something outside, eh?
Nice fella to start the day! Nice fella to start the day! Raise him up, raise him up! You like shit, eh?
Next up, I accompanied the wife to a swimming race of hers, and I was there with my latest subscriber at that point in time, who was my sister-in-law. Little did she know that I was doing videos.
I want to go to Paria, so I decided to YouTube Paria, only to find someone has a YouTube channel.
Oh.
And I ended up watching this person's video, and down to the end, I was like, this voice is sounding so familiar throughout the whole video.
So you didn't know it was
and
me?
Then I saw Lucy, I was like, he has a whole channel?
Yeah.
How cool. So then I binge watch all of your videos and all.
I hope you like and subscribe.
Of course I did. I clicked the bell notification.
Nice.
Yes.
Light work, Keith, light work.
We
on the kayak and we couldn't even find this man.
We couldn't keep up, we seriously couldn't keep up.
See everybody you're meeting.
And here they come, the home stretch. Come on, Carrie, Nadia.
Yay!
It have no friendship, no holding hands. No friendship, no holding hands. No, she left you. She left you. Go, Carrie. 3 kilometers in 1:17. What?
This had to be one of my luckiest days spearfishing. I just tell myself, today is the day I'm going to shoot my first kingfish. Nobody ain't asked me, but I tell everybody. And so said, so done.
Yes, Imran, hit and hope. Ha ha, boy, you can neck in this dirty water. What's this? I seen a little silver. Just make sure the GoPro on in case it's something epic. When this fish get here, they make like about a 90 degrees run. It didn't run straight out, it run like a 90 degree turn. And then after it catch itself, it make a next 90 degree turn. I still can't tell what it is, but I have the feeling in my guts that it's something epic.
Yo, watch for it, watch for it, eh? Yo, watch for
it. I've given Shano's the heads up to watch me because I feel like it's something special. I still didn't see where it was, but I done tap Shane. I was like, yeah, pass second shot in it. And he go in. Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god! It's a kingfish! The same way I get excited to see that kingfish, that kingfish get excited to see us. But in a reverse, it take off again. As I slowly pulling it in, Shane's trying to line up a shot, and I don't know he going to miss because that's happened. Sometimes it can be hard to land a second shot in a case like that, especially when you're so close and the fish fighting up a lot. And that is why I decided to go for the teal grab.
Is it on? Wow!
I have real shenanigans I could call upon from Tobago, but instead I go focus on the day I went behind the scenes commercial fishing offshore with Mark. I hold my first tuna and my second tuna. We had a few good days down in the bush, somewhere in the southwest too, and we learn and see all kind of different things. Tony finds something special, eh?
Hunter man's nut. So if the hunter eats this fruit now, he can go fast after the animal. If the animal eat the fruit, he will go faster. That's the name, Hunter man's nut.
Watch out! Right. Gatorade?
Gatorade in the bush.
Bush Gatorade.
Did I mention in the southwest we see and experience a whole heap of things? That includes the Chatham sulfur cliffs and mud volcano we found at the base of the cliff.
Yes, I!
Alright, we have no idea what we've seen here, but Tony, dig it up there, let me see. Nah, this is the spot. This is it.
Chatham sulfur cliffs.
This is it. Watch all the blackness all day. Oh no, man, what is this? What we have there, folks? It's a mud volcano.
Did I mention down in the southwest we see and experience and do all kind of thing?
Asian see we struggling with drone, direction. You see them help these poor fools and them, eh? You gonna carry up on a more direct route to it, and apparently there's more than one mud volcano down in the back there. We reach the first one? Asian, it's more than this?
Yeah. It's down train now, man.
we didn't find the exact mud volcano we was looking for, and you would think you would be disappointed by that. But we run into this, is Adrian, right?
Yeah.
We run into Adrian, and Adrian show you about, how much we checked there, about 6?
Yeah.
Totally worth it. And guess what? I gotta come back next time when the tide low, just to find the one I set out to find initially today. But we out.
And the last major thing I did was another wildlife video. That was recently dropped. Everybody who watching this channel is going to be familiar with it. So I just play a little piece of the wildlife in the end. And moving forward from this one, expect new, fresh content. Later.
It hurts. And I'm too sexy for Milan, too sexy for Milan, New York and Japan. And I'm too sexy for your party, too sexy for your party, no way I'm disco dancing. I'm a model, you know what I mean, and I do my little turn on the catwalk, yeah, on the catwalk, on the catwalk, yeah, I do my little turn on the catwalk.